derive from a little bit of the source text, so yeah. Welcome. Where tonight we are going to be doing some video editing with a fun piece of software called Kaden Live. So here's the website for Kaden Live here. Basically, a really kind of cool video editing software. It's open source, freely available, based off of KDE, MLT, Qt, uses Freeor video effects, and Lanspa. Pretty sweet. Pretty sweet software. And it's available, or let's check out some of the features it has. I haven't even really looked at this. It's got multi-track video editing. Good, you can use any audio video format, which is pretty clutch. I've used others that you have to convert, and it's just a pain in the ass. It's got configurable interface shortcuts. Cool. Didn't know that. A titler. Haven't even really used that yet. Many effects and transitions, I've checked them out, and there's quite a few, and they're good. Audio and video scopes, neat, but I don't know. Proxy editing, you can automatically create low resolution copies of your source clips to allow you doing the editing on any computer and render full resolution. Okay, yeah, cool. So yeah, it's a pretty decent little video editor, and it works for the purposes I'm using it for. You can download it here. There's instructions on putting it into distro. It says that a beta version can be downloaded for Windows. So let's unzip it. I don't know. So if you're running Windows, you could use it. And then there's this, but it's outdated. I would just recommend putting it on Linux. Always a good option. But yeah, I'm curious to see if there's anybody in the chat. I'm not even sure if it says that anyone's watching it. I think it will say if somebody's watching, so I'm guessing nobody's watching. But anywho, I came here to do something. Oh yeah, video editing. So, let's do that. The first step is to launch Kaden Live. I'm just gonna close this window because we don't need it. Same with this window. Just realized that the music that I'm using tonight is off of Soma FM Clementine. So I don't know if it's gonna be any copyright issues with it, but see what happens. Okay, so doing some video editing. The first step, you start up and it's like this. I don't know what the profile default, it says it's VGA. I want to do a different video profile, so I'll just go in. And we'll choose full HD, 1080p, 30 frames per second. It's generally good to choose a resolution that your video footage is in, or is mostly in. So that's why I'm choosing that one. That's what the phone gets. So opening it. So now we've got our new project there. And we want to drag some video files in there. So I've got some here. sounding of the hexalites. And it's just gonna like kinda load them in here. Kinda take a moment to do that, but you can still even work with them before it does that. Just gonna check which one's the newest or the oldest. This one's 1651 and that's 1734, 23, yeah, so this is the oldest, so I'm going to do it in chronological order so that it makes sense. And yeah, so I guess I'll start by dragging this video down here. Excelente. And then go add effect, motion, speed, and then I'm gonna, so as it is, we can kind of watch it a little bit, but it's just kind of boring. It's just like, I mean, it's not super boring, but it's just, it's too slow, it takes too long, no one wants to sit through, like, yeah, like, to get the idea of what's going on, you don't have to watch 10 minutes of cutting with scissors and sanding stuff, right? So we'll just speed that up using this speed. So again, we got to that by going add effect and motion speed, and we'll just go and bam. Now it's much shorter of a clip and it will play faster, and when it's rendered it's smooth. Not smooth right now, and that's just the way that it is when it's like this. But so now that we've done that, I'm gonna just zoom in here a little bit and I'm gonna drag the next one down to about there, and then I'm gonna go here and add a dissolve transition to this one, and then it will dissolve down to there. We can just kind of verify what that's going to look like here. Sure, if I start talking in this one, what? You know, this looks like I'm measuring stuff. Maybe I'm mumbling to myself, but thanks to you. So, effect, motion, speed, and then make this one 2000. And then we'll just continue along. Same sort of thing. Go add effect, motion, speed, and zip that up to the top, 2000. And the final touch, we'll put it in dissolve. This one, which I guess is the last video here. Right about there. Effect, motion, speed. could try and preview it, but it's a whole thing, but it's just going to be like that. It's not actually how smooth it will be. It will be, should play smooth, hopefully. Let's just kind of preview the transition. But. Pretty quick transitions here, but we'll see how it goes. Okay, so now that we've done all that, the next step is to render, and this is just a simple video. We haven't added any titles or anything in. That's just kind of, I just want to make fun little hyperlapse clips for a bunch of time, like in this case maybe 10, 15 to 20, 23, around 35 minutes is condensed down into like a minute and 40 seconds. So yeah, we'll just see how this looks once it's rendered. So, I'm going to choose H.264, and where am I going to render it to? Well, that's a tricky question. Let's go with videos, light builds, and then Hexalite. And call this one sanding, 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 and more sanding. Okay. Probably some other stuff too, but what is? So, at this point, we just go render to file. And I guess we just wait. So it says waiting. It just says waiting. So that's what we do, we wait, right? Yes, yes. So, well, there's one person watching. I wonder if that's Andrew. I see that Andrew Harvey liked it. It would be cool if it's Andrew. Pretty cool. But, yeah. I look forward to getting interactive with the chat these days on these live streams. You know, maybe do some like collab or something. Maybe have like do like live streams and like video live stream video conferencing and then like stream it live. And I don't know. It's weird. Weird ideas. Oh yeah, it's doing something. 35 minutes remaining. 35 minutes and 34 seconds remaining. Well, that's a while. I don't know. What could we do? What could we do for that time? I almost feel like having a nap. If it's gonna take that long, we could read more about Kaden live, I suppose. What was I looking up here? I was looking up makerspaces in Zurich. Been a little bit of a saga getting to this point. Just because, I don't know, I learned some things about routing and how the edges flake away. At first I thought it would be best to do it before I cut with the saw, but apparently it's best to do it after you cut with the saw. But I figured some things out and got it to a decent level. Maybe I can just switch over here and just go just this. And yeah, so this is a where I'm at with the Hexalite. Got one made in the background there, but that one's really raw. And this one's pretty raw, but I did quite a bit of sanding on it. It's like, actually, it's really smooth to touch. It's really smooth, but it's also kind of like wavy. It's sort of strange. But I didn't really sand in on the inside cuts because my electric sander wouldn't fit in there, so I might end up hand sanding that. I guess I could do that hand sanding while I'm waiting for this video to render. I suppose that's the thing, but I'd have to get some sandpaper. I'm wondering if people can hear me okay out there. If the levels are okay. I've just turned up my microphone volume just a little bit. I'm down the music, but yeah. I think it's probably good. But yeah, this video is gonna be about half an hour. I like the feel of it. I like how smooth it is. It's actually kind of worth it, but it's a lot of time to put in just like sanding, just to like make it smooth, when really I don't really care if it's smooth, but I kind of feel like other people might. They might be like, oh, it's all super rough, I don't really want that, but some people might really like that too. Like, I personally dig fucking stuff when it's rough and raw and rugged. So yeah, but this one's kind of the best that I've got so far. This one's even more raw, it's not even completely routed out properly yet. Same with this one. So this one too. These ones are really raw. Rough and rugged and rugged and raw. But I have to make those ones a little nicer at some point. I'm just doing one at a time. And yeah, I'm building this light. This one too. I think I'm gonna let go of this one. Yeah. I have to let it go to a good home. Cause I gotta paint red. And this seems like a way that maybe can get a little bit of money. And then if I get a little bit of money, then I can make more, and a little bit more, maybe. But, yeah. If nobody wants to buy them, I'm fine with keeping them, because they're pretty cool, and I think it'd be fun to bring festivals and events and stuff. And, yeah. So, either way, it's good. I should just keep making them. And making them evolve. Like, this is just one design. Got the record light design, and the triangle light. Many more geometries to come. Start getting 3D geometries and stuff eventually. But yeah. For now, this is where we're at. It's pretty cool. I think these things are pretty fun. So, suppose I could start soldering this one, but I'm humming and hawing about whether or not I should paint it, and also sand it more here, I think. Sanding it more here I can probably do by hand here, which I should do now. But the painting it, I don't have any paint. And I also don't have any money. So, yeah. Thinking this one may not get painted before it gets sold. And some people might dig it that way, and actually I'm the type of person who would dig it that way, not being painted and stuff. Just because I like it, the wood grain and stuff, the feel of it and stuff. But some people may want to paint it themselves anyways, so there you go, ready to paint, you know. Yeah, so I think there'll still be somebody, or I think people may, somebody still may want to even not paint it. Yeah, just some thoughts. Well, it's rendering. Let's see where it's at. Rendering. It is 17 minutes and 20 seconds remaining. Good fun. Let's see if there's anyone in the chat. Nobody in the chat. Well, I think I may take a nap. I think that's where I'm at. But, yeah, I mean, probably just as well, we're getting a little off topic off of video editing at this point, but, yeah, doesn't really matter. But yeah, I think it's time for a nap. So, I guess until next time, stay awesome out there. And if you dig what you were doing here, what I'm working on, and if you dig that sharing information on building these things, if you have any questions about building these things, let me know. And yeah, if you dig what we're doing and you want to support, we're opening up some channels for support to come in. The website should be back online shortly, and we also got a Patreon page. That's just sort of quietly out there, open to source, Patreon. If you feel like supporting, there are ways that you can do it there, and fun options to support the open source community as well. Yeah, so look forward to that. And yeah, please do let me know if you guys have any questions about these lights and building them, and if you want to get into them. If you want kits or want to purchase any, if you want me to build custom light fixtures for you, just hit me up, let me know. Cool. Thanks. Ciao for now. Peace.